Hello, everyone. Now we're going to present how Apache Ozone builds up high availability with RAP protocol. This is Li Chen. I'm currently senior engineer at Tencent. Also, I'm Hadoop committer and Ozone PMC. We will have other two engineers will join us for presenting this talk. Nanda from Cloudera. He is currently Hadoop PMC and Ozone PMC. Also, we have Shashik from Cloudera. He is currently Hadoop PMC, Ozone PMC, and Apache Redis PMC. Now, firstly, we're going to introduce what is Apache Ozone. Apache Ozone is a distributed key value store designed to scale to billions of projects and run clusters of thousands of nodes. Ozone supports RPC and S3 APIs as well as Hadoop compatible file system called Ozone FS. Hadoop Ozone is originally from Hadoop community and has become Apache top level project in 2020. And Ozone is now heavily used in production in Tencent. Now we're gonna look at Ozone's overall architecture. Ozone has two metadata manager, Ozone Manager and Storage Container Manager. Ozone Manager is managing a lot of control plane metadata, such as block info and file info. Storage Container Manager is going to manage all the nodes on the data nodes, health, heartbeats, and health reports. We also have data nodes for writing data and storing data, which is similar to what HDFS data nodes does. So Ozone's motivation is to resolve some of the challenges from HDFS. For HDFS use case, name node has scalability concerns, and there are a lot of file operation concurrency, which could cause problem or stuck. And HDFS also handles reports in name node as well, so there is heavily burden on the memory side. And name node is very slow to start up, especially for large clusters. So Ozone's motivation is to scale both namespace and block layer, also to scaling to trillions of objects, and we'll do a lot of optimization, especially for small files, which namespace has difficulties handling with. We also want to build a pretty versatile storage solution to use. So Ozone has a lot of basically a lot of use case in either EMR or Kubernetes. So there are many more deploying methods around Ozone, which can make EMR users or Kubernetes users pretty easy to deploy Ozone cluster. We just talk about Ozone Manager and the Storage Container Manager. Now we're going to let you know why we are so centric on the HA part. So this is basically Ozone's write process and read process. So client will send the request to Ozone Manager, and Ozone Manager will talk to will basically put a lot of block operations, container operations, and pipeline operations to SCM. And SCM also is responsible for handling container report, pipeline report, and node report from data nodes. So Ozone has already implemented Ozone Manager HA and the SCM HA in order to make the cluster more robust to handle a lot of operations or very high concurrency. Also, when a single OM or SCM is down, the cluster is easy to recover and still be able to handle the high concurrency requests. So this is pretty much why we're so centric in implementing Ozone HA in 2020 and 2021. So Ozone HA's goals is first for fast failing, fast failover process in ozone. Second, we need HA to have strong consistency, especially around metadata area. Third, we need to have transparent failover for the entire ozone clusters. Now we'll have Shashik to introduce Apache Redis, where we use Apache Redis for implementing Ozone HA overall.
Thank you, Lee. So let's now talk about Apache Redis and the basic ideas behind Apache Redis and how it is being used for Apache Ozone. So Apache Redis is an implementation of Raft consensus algorithm. It's an open source Java library, very actively being developed in the Apache community right now. So any of you, your friends or colleagues have an interest in it and want to contribute, please feel free to do that. Any sort of contribution is welcome and really appreciated. So typically a Redis cluster will typically have a leader, and so leader will be elected out of a quorum of nodes, and the other, so one guy will be the leader, other will become followers. Leader will basically be the central authority. Clients will send all the requests to the leader, and then leader will basically validate the request and create the transactions, and the same sort of transactions are replicated over to the followers. So let's talk about some rough basics. Typically, you will have a leader election mechanism where all the servers, when they start, they'll start as a follower, then randomly they'll become a candidate and start a leader election mechanism where each of the candidates will become a candidate. After becoming a candidate, will basically send out a request vote, and once a node gets majority of the votes, will become a leader, and other becomes followers. So, and I mean, the next mechanism is called append entries mechanism, where typically what happens is when the client sends any request to the leader will intercept that, validate the request, and then basically creates a log transaction, and it sends out the same sort of a request to the followers by a mechanism called append entry mechanism. So leader sends the append entry to the followers acknowledge the append entry request from the leader, and in cases where there are no client requests coming, so leader sends out empty append entry request to the followers. This becomes a means of arbitrating among the nodes in the cluster. So, and this is how essentially they maintain a leader forward relationship among the nodes of the cluster. So these are the basic standard Raft features we have. We have a relay election mechanism. So every node can become a candidate and start a relay election on a randomized time. And each of the relay election basically, each of the relay election event times out at a random interval on each of the nodes. So there are no chances of having a split vote or multiple leaders getting elected at the same time. So once a relay election is done, the leader basically accepts all the client requests, creates log transactions, and the same log is replicated to all the nodes in the servers. These servers will basically form a group called a Redis group, which is defined by a Raft group ID. So in any point of time, there's one leader of a Raft group and others are followers. It supports membership changes, so you can basically reconfigure your cluster at runtime. You can bump up the priority of certain nodes. You can basically add a node, remove a node. The replication factor in terms of the number of participating nodes can be changed at runtime without any downtime. And also has a log compaction feature. So typically you don't need to maintain the history of logs right from the beginning. A snapshot can be triggered periodically, which will basically keeps a point in time copy, and then every time when a node is added, it basically can send out a request to catch up with the other nodes in the cluster. So leader can basically send out the complete snapshot of the history of transaction which it has in terms of a single snapshot file, It doesn't need to basically send out a complete long log history to the newly added nodes. Redis, as we discussed, it's very pluggable. It's a Java library. Any services which or any sort of application which needs to use Redis can load it as a library. It is a pluggable state machine model where typically applications can define their state machine according to their own conveniences. There's a very, very basic example of a key value map, and also there's an example of a file store in Apache Redis. So you basically can just go and try out that, and we'll see what sort of the features Redis brings into the table. It has a pluggable RPC model. User can provide their own RPC implementation. Default implementations are done in gRPC, native Hadoop RPC, where gRPC gives you the complete implementation of a native client, and this is what is being used in Apache Ozone for metadata and data replication right now. And then it has a pluggable RAP log model, where applications again can define their own log implementation. The default implementation is that where it stores the log files in the local file system. So let's talk about the Apache Redis use cases now. So typically what happens is, whenever there is a need to replicate the server state or mutations or the logs to multiple machines, you can very well use Redis there. So the replication number, the cluster membership can be reconfigured at any point of time dynamically without having to bring down the cluster, and there is automatic leader election that is happening. You can basically tolerate node failures depending on how you configure the cluster. So at any point of time, if majority of the nodes are alive in the cluster, the cluster can keep on continuing its business as usual with tolerating all sorts of other failures like network or node going down, or network partitions happening. All sorts of failures are basically being handled on Apache Redis. So at any point of time, if the number of quorum nodes are alive and hard beating to each other, the clusters of the applications and keep on continuing working. Or if you need a highly available service, so typically when a server falls, you need another server to take up the charge and sort of this, and basically continue on the business. Apache Redis is just for you. It can automatically do the leader election without any manual intervention, as I told you. So unless and until the minimum quorum number of nodes are alive and hard beating to each other, it can keep on working. And there's a RAP client which basically does an automatic failover to the right leader. So if you use that, you can very seamlessly keep on working. So these are the typical use cases which Apache Redis has, and from now on my colleague Nanda will take on, where he will describe about how Apache Redis is being used internally in Ozone HR architecture overall for Ozone Manager and Storage Container Manager. Over to you, Nanda. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, Shashi. Coming to high availability of Ozone, we have two master services which are single point of failure. To make Ozone highly available, we have to implement HA for both Ozone Manager and Storage Container Manager. Let us first look at Ozone Manager. Ozone Manager is the namespace layer of Ozone. It stores information about volume, bucket, and keys. These information are stored in RocksDB. Ozone Manager also does access control. If we want to have HA for Ozone Manager, we have to replicate volume, bucket, and key information in more than one machine. This is done using Redis. In HA model, we have three Ozone managers running, which will form a RAF ring. With Redis leader election, one of the Ozone manager service will be elected as leader. All the client calls will be processed only by the leader. This is achieved by doing a leader check before processing any client request. After the leader check, authorization is done and the request is processed. The processed request is sent via Redis to the followers where the information is stored in RocksDB. Once there is acknowledgement from quorum, The processing of requests succeeds and the client is acknowledged. Since Ozone Manager handles all the client requests, we have to consider Ozone Manager's performance and the overhead introduced by Rattus layer. To improve the throughput of Ozone Manager, we have implemented buffering logic, where the requests are buffered before it is sent via Rattus. Now let's move on to Storage Container Manager. If we look at SCM, it maintains information about data node, pipelines, and containers. It also runs set of internal services to manage the data nodes, perform replication, create, manage pipelines and storage containers. To perform these tasks, SCM has the following internal services running: Node Manager, Pipeline Manager, Container Manager, Block Manager. Node Manager manages the data nodes. It checks the health of every data node and marks them as healthy, stale, or dead based on the last heartbeat time of data nodes. Node Manager also maintains information about all the registered data nodes. Data node level information are not stored in any persistent storage. They are learned by SCM after every restart via data node reports. For SCM HA, we have decided not to replicate data node level information via Rattus. Instead, the data nodes will now send reports to all the SCM, both the leader and the followers. Using the reports sent by data node, SCMs will update its data node information. The reports sent by data node via Heartbeat are node report, pipeline report, container report, and incremental container report. Pipeline manager manages the data pipeline using which client reads and writes data to the cluster. Pipelines are created and managed by pipeline manager. When pipeline becomes unstable or unresponsive, pipeline manager destroys them and creates a new one. Pipeline manager stores pipeline level information in pipeline table in RocksDB. During restart, the pipeline information are loaded by pipeline manager from the pipeline table. In SCM HA, we use Rattus to replicate all the pipeline related information and they are stored in all the SCMs. Pipeline level changes include pipeline creation, pipeline state change, closing of pipeline, pipeline deletion. Moving on to Container Manager. Container Manager manages storage containers. Storage containers are the unit of replication in Ozone. Container Manager creates and manages the container. When the container becomes full, Container Manager closes them and maintains enough replica for each container. If a container goes under-replicated, Container Manager re-replicates them on other data nodes. Container Manager stores container level information in container table in RocksDB. During restart, Container Manager loads the container details from container table. In HA, we use Rattus to replicate all the container related information and they are stored in all the SCMs. Container level changes include container creation, container state change, closing of container, container deletion. Block manager is responsible for allocation and deletion of blocks. SCM doesn't store block level information in any DB. Block manager only maintains blocks which are marked for deletion, not yet deleted. Once the block is deleted, the information is removed from block manager. The pending blocks for deletion is stored in deleted blocks table in RocksDB. In SCM HA, the information stored in deleted blocks table is replicated via Rattus and stored in all the SCMs. SCM HA uses Rattus to replicate pipeline, container, and block level information from leader to followers, and the information is then stored in RocksDB. Node level information are not replicated. They are updated using data node reports, which is sent to all the SCMs. SCM also runs background services to manage the cluster, With HA, there are set of services which should only run on leader node. These are all the set of services which should only run on leader nodes. Replication service, block deletion service, pipeline creation service, node health service. When there is a failover, the new leader will start this service and the old leader will stop all these services. Ozone architecture with both Ozone Manager and Storage Container Manager HA. There will be three Ozone Manager and three SCM nodes. One will be leader and other two will be followers. The data node will report to all the SCMs and send reports to all the SCMs. At Tencent, they did a comparison of performance between SCM non-HA and HA deployment. Here, the master column represents non-HA SCM. While implementing HA, we decided to have a switch to bypass RATIS. This is only for performance testing. This mode is same as non-HA but exercises HA code path. That is the column next to the master column, bypass RATIS. If you look at the other two columns, single RATIS and SCM HA, single RATIS is single node RATIS and SCM HA is three node RATIS ring. If you look at the rows, transaction per second and throughput, the impact of RATIS is not much. When the file size increases, there is no difference in throughput or TPS. That's all from us. Thank you all for your time.